What up though? DJ Star back with another On Feet video, and today we're discussing one of my favorite silhouettes of the Air Jordan line. But before we do that, please subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell so you know when I'm dropping new content. And also, please like and subscribe to the channel. It goes a long way to help the channel grow, and I'm still trying to reach those 500 subscribers in 30 days. So with that being said, today we're discussing the Air Jordan 4. And this particular silhouette was named the 11 Lab 4. It released in April of 2015 for a retail price of $250. It is currently reselling on StockX for about $409 with taxes and fees added to it. You're looking about $200 over retail. It's a slick shoe, but I'm not sure if it's worth it. And if you have a dead stock pair, you can sell it on StockX for $278, or it was I can't remember. Maybe it was $278, but after taxes and fees, yeah, it was $278, because after taxes and fees, you're under retail, which is like $244, so it's not even worth it. So with that being said, this is one of those pickups that early on in the career, I picked up from eBay a used pair, probably about 2016, 2017, I believe. I picked up this used pair, and this pair was funny in particular that when I bought the pair from the guy, he was supposed to send it in the original box, but when it showed up, he had just put two pairs of shoes in a mail package and sent it. It was just like weird. Like, hold on, bro. You said you had the box and you sent it like that. But I'm like, you know what? I'm not going to even trip. I'm going to just go ahead and grab, you know, just rock the shoe or whatever. And then I want to say 30 days or 60 days later, I get a notification from eBay saying the seller never got the money. So they just refunded it back to me. So I got a free pair of Jordan 4s for free. I couldn't be mad at it, so especially since he didn't send the box. So anyway, if you look at the shoe, it's a really unique shoe in itself, is because the whole upper of the shoe is all patent leather. All patent leather. So if you look at this right here, the tongue is done kind of thick, but it got the Jordan flight patch on it, Jumpman with the flight patch, and it's done in all patent leather. You swing it back, it's all leather on behind it, and the whole insole is done in leather as well. You go down to the top of the shoe, and as you notice, I did a lace swap. Actually, I just bought these a couple of weeks ago. Did a leather lace swap. I thought it would kind of set it off. I should have probably did white, but I didn't want to break the black up too much, so I kept it black, and it's a dope touch. Now, when you get over to your part right here, normally where it's breathable, it's not. It's patent leather with patent leather over it. The whole upper is done in a very smooth, nice patent leather. And if you can't see it on this one, it's actually creased. And these crease real easy, and they're really tight. If you go to the lateral side of the shoe, you'll see more of the same. This all patent leather, everything. I believe these are plastic. The wings are plastic, but everything else is patent leather all over the top of it. They did a glossy paint on the midsole, as you see right here. And right here on the outsole, black. You got a little bit of white, and then it's starting to chip because it is 5-6 years old, which is visible air unit right there. And that part was done in white all the way around. You get to the medial side of the shoe, and you get more of the same, just a patent leather finish that's really done really well, really, really well, with black stitching all through it. And you see right here again that gloss paint over your midsole, with your white part of the midsole sticking out, and black all around it. And you got your raised edges right here where your black stars go on your normal Jordan Air Jordan 4s. So that was pretty slick, and I like the finish on it. It looked like a classy shoe, even though it's a gym shoe. Then you get around to the heel of the shoe, you'll notice right here, your tab, all this is done in patent leather with a Jumpman in it, and it just looks really clean and smooth in my opinion. You just can't beat that Jumpman. I mean, Nike Air Jumpman, it's all the same to me. Depending on the shoe, if I like it, I love it, I'm not gonna trip. But you see all that's done in that black Jumpman right there. And as always, if you got a Jumpman on the back, on the bottom, you're gonna have a Jumpman on the bottom. And this is your traditional Air Jordan 4 type style traction. So very, very clean shoe in my opinion. I don't bust it out that much because I end up having to grab 11 and a half is all he had, and I can just fit it. Like, it just fits, and that's it. I have to wear a really thin sock with it too for it to be comfortable. And it's not comfortable being all day. Like, I only wear this shoe if I'm going to a classy event where dress shoes are the standard, then I pull these out. Especially if the suit or whatever I'm wearing, tux or whatever I'm wearing, is all black with a little bit of white. It really sets it off. And it's a dope shoe in my opinion. So tell me what you think about the Air Jordan 4 11 Lab. I was thinking about going back and getting another pair of my actual size 12 so to be more comfortable. But the retail is like $200-something over retail, I'm good. I pass. I don't need it that bad just to replace the shoe. So with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and get out of here. So please subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell so you know when I'm dropping new content. And then always, make sure you like, comment, and share on the videos. It goes a long way to help the channel grow and help you get to those 500 subscribers. I appreciate you, and I'm gone. Love, peace, and prosperity. I'm out.